This is a podcast 75 years in the making. It's a podcast about history.
Bring pork chops and applesauce.
It's a podcast about family.
The love is deep for her.
But most importantly, it's a podcast about you.
Sounds kind of weird.
It's season 3 of the official Holiday World Podcast, chronicling our 75th year of family fun.
Friends, welcome back to season 3 of the official Holiday World podcast. This is season 3, episode 19, the one with the in-park interviews. Again, today is Friday, September 24th for us, but we expect to release this episode around October 3rd. In episode 18, we kind of did a brief overview of Happy Halloween weekends, but you know, things can change and ebb and flow as you get closer to the event. And so we caught up with Lauren Crosby, our director of events and entertainment and also fourth generation owner, and then also our food and beverage director, Lexi, to find out all of the what we need to be doing for Happy Halloween weekends. So sit back, relax, and enjoy. We're at that really funny part of the season where, again, it is hard to get everyone at the same table. So we're going to do it this way again. So if you guys have any suggestions of man on the street or lady on the street interviews that you would like Sabrina to capture, let us know in the feedback. So I have Lauren with me here. How are you this morning, Lauren?
Doing great.
Doing just skippy.
Yeah.
We just wrapped media day, so we've got Happy Halloween weekends fresh on the brain. So we got to see Monster Mash show. It's incredible.
I'm pumped.
Yeah.
I'm pumped.
It's such a fun show. I know around the staff that everyone loves Halloween. I mean, it's just a fun time, and the park gets a facelift. What do you think?
As I said before, remember, Holiday World is the cake.
It is.
Halloween is cake balls.
It is. Yes, it's the best. So it's the icing and the cake batter, and it's just the good stuff. So what do you think, what did we expect with Monster Mash this year?
Oh my gosh. So it's going to be a very similar format to what we saw in 2019, but there's a new monster and, you know, the gang is back, but like there's some new antics, like there's some fresh dance moves.
That's awesome.
I feel like I just aged myself.
the jazzy beats all the kids will love. But yeah, so it's, you know, the costumes are fresh, so you know, we had a great time with Celebrate this year, but it's really exciting to see the Halloween shows return and the monsters. Like you said, we've got a fresh monster for everyone to meet and a whole new chunk of the show, and it's amazing.
Absolutely.
And then also we have another familiar face returning to the stage, a certain doctor.
Yes, Professor D.R. Holiday, if you will, his wacky workshop of wonders. Yes. Try to say that yes. Three times fast. The professor's back. We're so pumped. We got to meet him for the first time in 2019, mm-hmm. and then we weren't able to have him come hang out with us last year, and I really missed the professor, so
yes.
I'm very, very pumped to see him back in action. And I imagine he's got some new inventions cooked up, so
right.
We're going to have to check those out immediately.
Absolutely.
And everyone else should, too.
Yes, you definitely need to come see him. He was a part of our Kitty's Digital Halloween last year.
Yes.
So we got a little taste, but yeah, I'm excited to see, like you said, what inventions he's come up with, and I'm sure he'll have lots of puns. And he's a really fun, like, I know, like, Monster Mash is a whole family show. There's music for everyone. But our magic show is the same way. Like, I feel like as an adult and a parent in the crowd, like, you can enjoy it as well.
Oh my gosh. It's for everyone. Yeah. I mean, I think the professor says it's geared a little for, like, the younger kids, but mm-hmm. who am I kidding?
Right.
Like, I love it probably just as much as any kid does, so.
Yeah. And I think the true queen of Halloween is Kitty. And so
it's her party.
It is.
It's all her party.
It's all about her.
I mean,
so she has her own dance party.
Absolutely. Kitty's Dance Spooktacular. Ooh, I know.
Spooky.
I know. We had to give her a jazzy new name,
yes.
You know? I mean, well, she's moved venues.
Mm-hmm.
She's now going to be in Hoosier Theater. So, I mean, you know, the queen, we have to give her a proper throne.
Nice.
So, and you get to check her out multiple times a day now. It's not just a one-time thing anymore. Multiple times a day, her and her friends dancing it out. Come and join them. Dance in your seat. Dance in the aisle.
Nice.
Yeah, have
I mean,
a good time.
Out of respect, I feel like you need to stand for Kitty, but I mean, that's just me. But Yeah, so she's not on the Trail of Treats anymore. She'll be up on a Hoosier. So
yes.
And what's going on down in Splash and Sabari Plaza?
We'll have our trick-or-treat trail once a day in the evening. Go check out the website for times because I don't remember off the top of my head. Nailing it.
Drop that here. Check the podcast wall and we'll drop all that here. And that way too, you can drop the show schedule and...
all the good stuff.
All that.
But yeah, the trick-or-treat trail... oh my gosh, there's so much fun stuff. I mean, obviously you're going to get some candy, but we also have mini pumpkins. Yay! So take it home, paint it, decorate it, whatever you want. Use it as a doorstop.
Yeah.
But then also this year, we're very pumped. So we have been participating in the Teal Pumpkin Project for several years now, trying to offer something for, you know, any kid that has any sort of food allergies. We've historically given out little coloring books. But this year, I'm so excited. We have actual Holiday World coloring books with characters from Scare-B&B and Kitty and Hollow Dog. And it's the most adorable thing I've ever seen. And I can't wait for... people to get it
and
color
like,
in it.
Like Ashley and Steven's team worked on that.
Yes.
So it was created in-house. And
yep.
Some of that started last year out of Kitty's Digital Halloween and kind of grew. And some of our team members, family members got involved. So it's kind of a labor of just the whole team coming together and making the best out of 2020 and then sharing that over in 2021. So
absolutely.
So a fun part of Happy Halloween Weekends is it's everyone's favorite Holiday World attractions plus some new ones. Can you tell us more about what those are?
Absolutely. So we have three amazing themed walkthrough attractions. We have Hollow Dog's 3D Adventure, which is up in Christmas Plaza, and you get to put on 3D glasses.
Oh.
You get to go help Hollow Dog and Kitty find their Halloween candy.
Yes. And it's a full sensory experience.
Oh, absolutely. Mm-hmm. It's so much fun. So that one's like super, super duper family friendly.
Yes.
There are like a few like startle elements, but it's pretty few. We also have Scare-B&B in Pilgrim's Plaza. That one is this whole fun little group of characters and they have a Scare-B&B. Yes, that is a play on words.
And it's Marilyn.
Yes, Marilyn. She's a vampire.
Yes.
And her friends, I can't even remember all of them, but they're so...
like a full cast.
Yes, but they're cute and adorable.
Mm-hmm.
But you get to walk through her mansion and there's fun to be had. And again, a few startles, but totally family friendly.
Mm-hmm.
It's a blast. There's a cage maze. So
yes.
Like you can see the exit, but you're like, how do I get there?
I took media through it today and got like, we had to stop like three times. It's daytime right now and you can very clearly see through and I got lost. So
it will happen. Yes.
Yeah, Marilyn's mansion will get you.
And then our last walkthrough attraction is Carnival Chaos. And that is also in Christmas, but on the other side of Santa's Merry Marketplace. That one is a little bit older, so the younger kids might not be okay with that.
Yeah.
It's got a few more startles. Fair warning, there is a clown. So if you are...
If
you have a thing with that, then this is not for you.
Yeah.
But it's, you're walking through like an abandoned carnival and it's a little creepy.
Yeah.
But it's... it's fun. It's, again, as you said, sensory, all kinds of things. There's a mirror maze. Again, kind of like the cage maze. You can, like, see the exit because
yes.
of the mirrors bouncing
right.
off of each other, but you have, like, zero idea which way to go, and you're also, like, I might be walking on the path, but I might also be walking into a wall.
Yeah, myself.
So. Yep. It's fun. Yeah, so that one's always fun. And then not... indoors, it's outdoors.
Mm-hmm.
So if that's, you know, if you're trying to stay outdoors, we have a lovely corn maze.
Ooh.
I mean, you know, what other theme park can have a corn maze?
It's the most Indiana thing we can do. I love it. I'm here for it.
Holiday World, we love a good pun. The flag. So if you get lost, so corn mazes make me a little anxious because I don't know, like it's maybe a little claustrophobic, like kind of plays on that, but also the idea of being lost with my children in it, but
I feel that, yes.
They love it. They just run, though. Like, they don't, there's no strategy. They're just running, and they
usually get it pretty good. But I love that there's flags.
Yes. Yes. So there's stations throughout the maze. And if you get lost, you can send the flag up and yes. someone will come and find you and help you out.
Yes.
Yes. So you're never truly
yes.
lost or abandoned. Yeah.
So if you get confused,
yes.
then you can get back.
Mazed and
yes.
confused.
Yes.
yes. Oh, so good. But yes, there are two corn mazes.
Yes.
One is much easier and smaller and the other is much larger.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, if you're a beginner, there's one for you. And again, how much more Indiana can we be? We said, you know what, why don't you take a hayride to the
yes.
corn maze? So you can either walk or take a hayride. So it's a good time.
Nice. And that's just past, like, if you're going towards the Thunderbird, like that Pilgrim's Plaza there, like, you'll see it.
You'll go past,
ride.
Yes, you'll go past Pilgrim's Plaza, and rather than going up the hill to Thunderbird, you'll go to the, what we call the fireworks viewing area.
Mm-hmm.
You'll head out that way, and that's where you will find your transportation.
your chariot.
Yes, to the corn maze. And fair warning, if it's been a rainy week,
mm-hmm.
the corn maze
yeah.
will be muddy.
Yeah.
It's outdoors. We can't fix it. I'm sorry.
You can only control what we can control.
Yes. Yes.
Not
so
things.
Just putting it out there.
Yeah. What I love too is, you know, we worked so hard. We weren't able to have Halloween last year. But our attractions team, our events team, entertainment, we've all worked really hard to make sure it's a safe event. You know, we've kind of made some modifications through the event to make sure, you know, the super high touch areas aren't there. And, you know, anything, any opportunity, we really try to think through any of those
mm-hmm.
that, you know,
and
the
attractions team is on it. Like
mm-hmm.
we've been talking through them, like with the whole, through everything. And they, because there are some high touch things that we just can't eliminate. They're a part of the maze.
Right.
So they have a plan to go through that and clean that
mm-hmm.
regularly. So yes, we've thought through pretty much everything.
Yeah.
So we don't want anyone to worry whenever they come.
All right. Well, thank you very much, Laura.
Absolutely.
Want to know a secret? The best time to buy season passes is always right now. It's that simple. We believe in transparent pricing, so there's no game to play and no complications. Prices increase throughout our off-season, so hurry and buy now. We have 3 different passes with different perks, so go to holidayworld.com/passes to pick the pass that fits your family best.
Want to make a suggestion or have questions for the Pod Squad? There are more ways than ever to reach out to the podcast.
Find at Holiday World on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, and use the hashtag HOWOPO to let us know you're talking about us.
You can now call us. Dial 812-937-4401 and type in extension 8081 to get to the HOWOPO voicemail box.
Leave your questions and feedback for us there, or you can email us at podcast@holidayworld.com. either with a written message or with a voice memo.
Again, reach out on social media to @HolidayWorld and use the hashtag HOWOPO or call us at 812-937-4401, extension 8081, or send us an email to podcast@holidayworld.com.
For happy Halloween weekends, I'm gonna be a soaring Thunderbird.
I'll be a real bird, the Raven, flying through the woods and over the water.
I'm feeling like a pilgrim on the voyage, going over one of the world's steepest drops.
Huh, guess I'm a mind reader. I already bought our Holiday World tickets.
Wow! Yeah!
Ooh! Be whatever you want at Holiday World each weekend through October. Do a corn maze, walk through the scare B&B, and go trick-or-treating. Get tickets at holidayworld.com.
All right, guys, and now we're going to head on over to Lexi at Plymouth Rock Cafe and see what's on the menu for Happy Halloween Weekends. I'm here here with Lexi. She is our food and beverage director. Lexi, thank you for joining me today.
Absolutely. So glad to be here.
We just wrapped up media day and, you know, our team just kills it. I mean, the attractions team did awesome with showing off the Scare B&B. Lauren's already talked about food. Matt just talked about, you know, the event. And you got to talk on air about the food. So you're just all ready to go. We got to see it today. It looks amazing. What item are you most excited for?
Oh, that is so hard to say. I love fall. Mm-hmm. And so I got to try our hot apple cider today, and it was delicious. So I was very excited about that. But I have to say, we have a haystack burger, and I'm really excited to try that. I've tried the components, but I haven't tried it all together yet. My food team did, and they said it was amazing.
Yeah, we walked by it. I didn't get to eat it, but I got to walk by it, and it smelled phenomenal. Like, just the barbecue smelled amazing, and just the onion fries add just, like, a nice crunchy, or
onion straws.
Yes, onion straws on top, and it's really good.
I know, and so fall.
Yes.
You know, burger with barbecue and onion straws, like, just amazing.
That's what I love is, you know, we have all these, of course, for Holiday World, and we love our sweet treats, and everything at Candy Cane Confectionery is, you know, like, the spot for all the fall sweet treats, but we also have a lot of, like, actual nourishment. I mean, if you're going to make it to the full park in the day, you need some actual food, probably. So I love that we have some fun food items also that are actual food.
Yes, me too. And we have some really great things for people to try, so I'm excited. I got to try our chicken enchilada soup. Mm-hmm. Apparently that's a really big favorite, and so we wanted to bring that back. We are keeping our tomato soup and grilled cheese at Plymouth Rock, which we actually had that today.
It was so good.
Oh my gosh, fantastic. Yes. And then we have a new gluten-free chili. So, you know, when you think about fall, you just think about, like, those yummy soups and things.
What I love is, you know, like, we have all the gluten-free options, and they don't, none of them that I've tried, I can usually pick up on that stuff. They don't taste gluten-free. Like, that chili, if you would not have told me, I would have never known.
No, I agree. It's phenomenal. Like, probably my favorite chili that I've had, other than, you know, of course, what I make myself.
Right.
Because everybody has their own chili, right?
Yes, absolutely. The great debate of, you do noodles or no noodles?
I'm a no noodle girl.
Me too. That's a goulash for me. I'm sorry if that's a controversial take for the podcast. We tried to keep it pretty neutral. At our house, that's a goulash. But yeah, for chili, we keep the noodles out of it. But
I'm on board.
Yes. Yeah. So we've talked about the haystack burger. We've talked about some of the apple items. What else we got?
Yes, so we have a new pizza that I'm very excited about. The one that's going to be nice and hearty is a barbecue chicken pizza.
Yum.
I know, it's so delicious. Has some red onion on there as well.
Ooh, perfect.
Yes, it's delicious. Yeah, I'm trying to think some other fun things that we have. At Scoop Shop, we have a pumpkin pie flurry.
Ooh, yum. And it actually has like an actual pumpkin pie in it.
It has a whole piece of pumpkin pie in the flurry. Yeah, so it's delicious.
Yeah, I know last year we did the food photography day, and I just thought, you know, it's the name. You guys squirt some flavoring. No, they legitimately put a piece of pie in the blender.
So yes.
Pretty cool to watch you guys make that.
It is. It's delicious. And then, let's see, some other fun things. We have a new pepperoni pizza stick.
Ooh, fun.
I know. So just a take on our breadsticks, but just, you know, kind of loading them up with some things, almost like a loaded breadstick, you know, has sauce and cheese and pepperoni. So that's going to be wonderful. One thing I really love is that we're adding candy corn to our kettle corn for the fall.
It's like my two favorite things together.
Yes, I love candy corn so much. And so I'm so excited to be able to add those two things together, because I can say I probably buy at least one bag of kettle corn a week.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I actually have a bag in my car, and it's kind of been my breakfast this week.
That's nice.
So good.
It is. And let's see. We are going to also have, let's see, what else do we have here? Oh, gosh, I almost forgot. We're going to have a barbecue cheese dog at Hot Diggity. And it's going to have those yummy onion straws on top of it. It's barbecue sauce with cheese and then the onion straws on top. So that's going to be delicious as well.
All right. So like I said in the beginning, so we have all of this like substantial food. You've got your protein source. Now, our favorite way to wrap up a day at the park is to stop at Candy Cane Confectionery and Marketplace, just all the goodies there. What are we going to have there?
Yes, so as you're, you know, exiting the park or even throughout the day, you know, just depending on, you know, when your sweet tooth kicks in, we have some really fun pumpkin cake balls.
We have an apple pie caramel apple that we're adding in for the fall. We have some really fun fudge treats. Definitely fall, you know, Halloween colors. And so a lot of yummy things there. We do have a new Rice Krispie treat that we just tried, and it's amazing. It's like a whatchamacallit.
That's so cute.
So it has, yeah, it has the caramel and chocolate. It's so delicious. And then we have some really fun Halloween-themed Rice Krispie treats, cupcakes. I mean, we just went all out with the Halloween theme. Yes. And then on your way, if you're exiting the park, you definitely have to stop and get a pumpkin funnel cake. It's so wonderful, which I love pumpkin anything.
So it's all of your favorite fall things in one stop. I mean, like, you don't have to bounce around to a bunch of different areas. You literally can come to Holiday World, get all your apple things, get all your cherry things, all your pumpkin, all here, right?
All of it, yes.
All right. Well, thank you, Lexi, so much for taking some time out to chat with me. And we can't wait to go out and try all your masterpieces in the park.
Awesome. Thank you. Can't wait to see everybody.
Phew. We have worked our way through the park today and through another episode. Thank you again to Lauren and Lexi for taking the time to chat with us. I hope that you guys can hear through our voices and just how excited we are about Happy Halloween Weekends, to have it back this year after not being able to enjoy it last year. We all hope that you get a chance to experience it yourself, all the food, the smells, and the experience that is Happy Halloween Weekends. Our team works really hard to make it happen every year, and I think our passion really shows through. And with that, I'm putting my cart in park. And congratulations, you have worked your way through the park with Sabrina through another Holiday World podcast. Please join us in 2 weeks during your next commute, cleaning session, etc. for our next episode, season 3, episode 20. We'll see what the title is. Thank you to all our behind the scene pod squad and our pod squad members who are busy doing work to make Happy Halloween Weekends happen. Honestly, I love our whole team and I just couldn't imagine making this magic happen with anyone else. And thanks to all of you for continuing to listen and interact. If you're looking for ways to support Holiday World and the Ho-Wo-Po, be sure to subscribe and tell all your theme park loving friends and rate us if you have that option. We want to hear your feedback and we'd love to hear our listeners' voices instead of our own. Call us at 812-937-4401, then dial 8081 to get Steven's long but informative instructions. Thank you to all our listeners we hear from regularly. It really means a lot to us. Share your feedback with us at podcast@holidayworld.com or reach out to us on social media, especially on Twitter, using the hashtag HoWoPo.
This has been Season 3 of the official Holiday World podcast, a production of Holiday World and Splash and Safari in Santa Claus, Indiana. Listen to the latest episodes and subscribe at holidayworld.com/podcast. Thanks for being a part of our story as we celebrate 75 years of family fun.
Some families, they hand down things like antique bird cages.
Thanks.
In others, a long-forgotten accordion. But for the past 75 years at Holiday World and Splash and Safari, we've passed down the love of family fun in the form of roller coasters, water rides, and unlimited smiles.
Awesome! Let's go now!
Get tickets at holidayworld.com.